Let's unwrap some of the presents.
I am bored. What should I do?
Ah, ich weiß.
So, während mein Haar dunkler wird, weil ich mir gerade die Haare färbe, wie ihr sehen könnt, sieht ziemlich albern aus. Aber da ich gerade eh nichts machen kann, dachte ich mir, ich gebe euch mal ein Update, was so mein Abnehmen-Vorgang angeht. Ich bin jetzt bei Tag, warte mal, ich habe mir hier so ein Journal gemacht, so ein kleines Tagebuch. Ich bin bei Tag 15, also 25 Tage habe ich eigentlich schon mich gesund ernährt. Ich habe quasi größtenteils jedenfalls, bis auf ein, zwei Ausnahmen, immer die Süßigkeiten, Chips und so weiter weggelassen und Cola. Und ich habe auch versucht, wenig zu trinken, so alkoholmäßig. Habe, wie gesagt, jetzt 25 Tage hinter mir. 15 Tage von diesen 25 Tagen habe ich trainiert. Das werde ich hoffentlich noch ein bisschen steigern können, aber gerade am Anfang war es natürlich sehr schwierig. Jetzt trainiere ich fast jeden Tag, habe dann einmal in der Woche einen Ruhetag, manchmal auch zwei, wenn ich halt ein Wochenende sehr beschäftigt bin. Und ich fühle mich auf jeden Fall fitter. Ich merke auch, weil ich ja auch mich dementsprechend ernähre, wie ich Muskelzuwachs bekomme. Alles wird so ein bisschen straffer. Es ist wirklich ein tolles Gefühl, kenne ich ja vom letzten Mal auch schon. Nur dieses Mal mache ich es, glaube ich, ein bisschen besser, weil ich wirklich versuche, auch durch Kalorienzählen genügend Kalorien reinzukriegen. Weil letztes Mal hatte ich, glaube ich, nur so 1800 Kalorien am Tag gegessen und dann natürlich auch richtig abgenommen. Aber das ist dann auch wieder alles raufgekommen später, weil es viel zu wenig war. Ich esse jetzt mindestens immer so 2600 bis 800. Eigentlich, glaube ich, muss ich sogar noch mehr. Manchmal sind es auch über 3000 Kalorien am Tag, vor allem wenn man trainiert, dann muss man ja nochmal eine Schippe draufpacken. Und ja, bis jetzt läuft es ganz gut, wie gesagt. Ich habe bis jetzt noch nicht viel abgenommen. Ich bin sogar wieder bei 95 Kilo, aber da Muskeln ja schwerer als Fett sind, mache ich mir da eigentlich keine Sorgen. Ich werde jetzt einfach weitermachen, ich werde mich gesund ernähren, ich werde trainieren und dann kann es ja eigentlich nur besser werden, also naja. Und tada, alles fertig, all done. Now I'm gonna go to the hairdressers to get these a bit shorter, and then I need to do some work actually. I want to prepare the German Christmas songs video. Need to get up, need to do this whole Bavarian German get up and sing Glöckchen klingelingeling, klingelingeling, kling. I know, some of you will hate me for this, but I have fun doing it, so that's what's gonna happen. Just sent off the first letter of the Get Germanized Advent calendar. So, yes, I'm doing it. I'm really sending them off. You can see the post office over there with a yellow sign. I can't really see it on the camera, not that well. But it's there. I send it off, promise. And now I'm gonna get a haircut. It's St. Nikolaustag, St. Nick's Day. And today I'm gonna show you what that is all about. Presents, of course. So guys, this is what Nikolaustag looks like in my family, at least sometimes. Because we don't have boots, we use little plates like this and put like cookies in it and have little presents from Saint Nick, little Santas, chocolate Santas, more presents. And usually there's a whole array of those plates on the ground, but my brother already took them, so that's why there's only mine. Let's unwrap some of the presents. It's mostly like little things like socks or a jumper, stuff like that. So I expect some socks in here. Maybe. Yes. Christmas socks, very nice. I don't have Christmas socks yet, I don't think. They feel very nice and comfy. Nice. And what do we have here? This is, what is this? Ah, I believe it's shaved like, oh no, it's no shaving device. What is this? I don't know, it's really hard to open this with one hand. A light bulb. It's energy saving light bulbs for my kitchen. That is a very selfish present, Santa, so that the energy bill isn't that high. Great. I suspect there's one more then. Yes, here it is. I'll leave it in here for now. Well, actually this is another one. Yeah, all right. And what is this? This feels like could be a jumper of sorts.
It's a red towel, Christmas style towel. No, not really Christmas style, but it's nice and soft. So definitely something I can use in the future.
Towels, socks. But like I said, it's a little present for St. Nick's Day. And of course a plate filled with goodies. Little cookies, chocolates and such. Oh, I know what the next one is.
A mustard colored pajama. Oh God, Santa. This one is special.
Well, I don't know if I will show you me wearing this ever, but yeah. All right, I'm about to work out again. I'm at 94.2 kilograms after like 30 days of healthy eating. So I lost a kilo, which is not enough, obviously. And what I did wrong probably was like I ate too many calories every day, like 3,000 or something like that. Because I did that, because like on purpose, because I thought last time I ate way too little. I ate like 1,800 or so, which obviously was too little, but helped me lose weight quick, fast. Like in 3 months, I lost 20 kilos or so, which is like, what, 43 pounds? Don't know if that's too fast, probably. Anyways, this time, what I'm gonna do, because one of you guys suggested actually that I should eat about 2,200 to 2,300, and Tony Horton said in his health and nutrition guide as well, 2,200 is like a good amount when you want to lose weight, because you burn about 400 calories with the workouts and blah blah blah. Anyways, it came down to 2,200 as well. So I was like, oh, if two people or if many people say that, then I will just give it a try. I mean, it's still 400 calories over the amount that I ate last time. So I think it's a good compromise, and that's what I'm gonna try. And I'm gonna keep you updated, of course. Now I'm gonna do cardio. And another good trick that I have learned from Tony is, instead of just working out until you can't anymore, like do push-ups until you feel bad and think like, okay, this is all I can do, you have to set a number in your mind, like 15 push-ups, for example. And if you can only do 10, then take a little break, 5 to 10 seconds, and then catch your breath, and then try to do 5 more. And if you still can't do them, well, you take another break until you reach the 5. That way you do more and your muscles are still activated, even if you take like a 5 to 10 seconds break, and you don't plateau as easily. You like gain all the time. At some point I will have to increase the weights, I think, because if you do too many reps, then I think your white muscle cells, is that correct, get more triggered than the red ones. And that means you don't... I don't know what I'm talking about, actually. Maybe you guys can help me out in the comments. But I know that more less reps with more weight triggers the muscle better, I've heard, than other way around. So I'm gonna try that at some point at least. Because I still feel like I'm catching... Like I need to catch my breath quite often. I have like breathing problems after like I do 10 push-ups, then I need to stop and catch my breath because I feel like I can't inhale properly while I do them. I don't know if that's normal, probably because I'm not in shape yet. So yeah, like I said, I'm gonna keep you updated. Living the life, guys, watching Supernatural on the computer, eating some nommies with tomato stuff, and I just got a letter from one of you guys with a cute Chari sticker. This is super cute, isn't it? And here's a little cat, and here is a little another little cat. This letter is from Nancy Allred. Thank you very much, Nancy. I really appreciate it. Haven't opened it yet, but I'm already happy about the letter because there's so many cute animal stickers on there. I'll show you guys the rest as well. This is super cute, isn't it? Oh God, and this one too. Oh my God. Oh my God, it gets even cuter. How is it even possible? And here, he's snowboarding or something, or surfing. That's super cute. I reckon he's snowboarding because he got the jumper on. Wow, that is one pretty card. Welcome Christmas. The little elves. At least I think they're elves. Yes, they are. Super cute. They look like the ones from The Grinch, kind of, right?
Winston says, hey Dominic, I just wanted to wish you a Merry Christmas. I hope you have a wonderful holiday. Keep warm, Nancy Oren. Aw,
thank you so much, Nancy. A Merry Christmas to you as well. Frohe Weihnachten. And I saw you wrote that on here as well. Happy holidays to you. The whole world is filled with bright holiday spirit. You can see it and feel it and touch it and hear it. It's in every smile and each merry hello. Hope the goodwill will find you wherever you go. Happy holidays to you.
From Hallmark. Ah, Dr. Seuss. Ah, that's what that was from.
I remember those thingies.
Look, guys, I got another Christmas letter. And we're gonna open it together, as per usual.
That is a very pretty card. I love it. Very nice, from UNICEF. Very nice. Very, very nice. And inside we got a little letter by Monica Molenda. Dear Dominic, greetings from Michigan. I just wanted to say thank you for your Get Germanized videos. I've wanted to learn German for a long time, but my high school didn't offer it, so I've had to learn it on my own. Your videos have been both very helpful and entertaining. My German still isn't good, too good, but I hope someday I can be good enough to write fan mail in it. Vielen Dank und frohe Weihnachten. Thanks and Merry Christmas, Monica.
Thank you very much, Monica. I am very happy about this card. It's pretty and it goes on my wall. Maybe not there in front of Shari, but here. That's nice. Isn't that nice? Thank you again.